Okay, I'm going to actually be quite silly. I have not been practicing my English. I have come to the conclusion that after all is said and done, they are completely different. You have the British English, you have the Irish English, you have the American English, and they are all vastly different. Different tonations, different clips of the wording. So today I'm just heady set using my particular British accent. Now my British accent is perhaps different than your British accent. And I'm like, why? Why are you so different? Perhaps it is the persons that you have known from Britain. You will pick up a little bit of their tongue, so to speak. Perhaps it is the actual way you have built your own particular brogues within your mouth, and you cannot speak any other way when you go into English. When you're speaking with English, it is like, well, no, it will not allow a lilt, perhaps. You cannot do the lilt, as in Ireland has it. We have the Irish lilt. Very difficult. It's a very difficult one. You may have to stay there 2 years, 3 years, until it starts to work into your tone. The Irish lilt is near impossible right away. Unless, well, maybe you are accustomed to people around you that speak that way, and so it becomes easier. Okay, so right now, this is my British, and this has been my British, oh my gosh, forever, I believe. And I have not been able to back off. It seems so hoity, doesn't it? It seems so tidy, hoity-toity, and all of this. But it's the way it is. It's the way it is. It is my tone. It is my British. And I can't change it. I cannot change it. There is no way. I cannot go into a swathi. It is not easy. It is not easy. If you want to take your voice into a swarthy tone, one more of a merchant, I will say, a street merchant, you want to be a street merchant tone, well, that would be more guttural. So you'll have to lower the clippancy, lower your speed, and be lazier. Be lazier in your jaw. I'm not kidding here. You have to be lazier in your jaw. You have to also less tight, less tight. There is a tightness in the tone here. Tightness practically in your teeth, a little bit. But yeah, there's a tightness in your tongue when you are speaking in British brogue, and it's gonna go with your muscle tones. You know, the voice you'll find of your accent will be with your muscle tone that is in your mouth. That's going to be the easiest. It's going to be the first one that comes into play. You see. So here I am. This is my easy tone. I can try to do a Canterbury street merchant, but it's not going to be easy. So it would be more of not a character typecast for me, but for others, very simple, very simple. So let's look at all of these variances and why. Why does a person talk a specific way and another on that island? The island of Britain is vast disparities of who isms. And often you can just hear the tone for a moment and go, oh, I believe I don't want to talk to you ever. You're not in my league. You're not in my, I will say, my class league. You're not in my peerage class. So, no, I'm not really interested in your group. You can go over there and I will stay over here. And that's the way it is. That separation has been going on in Britain just in the tonations we speak, and that's, there's nothing we can do, really. That is not something that's going to be easy to fix, is it? When we talk about fixing the classes in Britain, and everybody being friends, and holding hands and saying this is a wonderful world, I don't believe it's going to be that easy an undertaking. Because when you are looking at, whoa, she's talking a little uppity, isn't she? You know, that's the type of person that would be like, just well, they don't want anything to do with me either. You know, they'll just be, well, that's enough. That's enough of her. She doesn't belong with us. She doesn't like jive in our jungle, so to speak. So yes. So we have quite fun in my particular little group, my little accent peerage class. We have fun, but we don't always jive with the others, and that group doesn't jive with us, and that's the way it goes. And there are very many levels. Britain is wonderful. I don't find so many levels in Ireland, but in Britain, there just seems like hordes and hordes of steps and steps. Like, which step are you on? You know, where are you with your tonations? Are you at the top? Are you at the bottom? Are you in the middle? Are you vacillating in between? You know, who are you really? It's quite interesting. Quite interesting, yes. So, and often you'll find, you know, when you go into, it is a language. It is as a language, it's as speaking French, it is as speaking Latin. It is a language. It is moving the brain. Here is my brain. Here, it is moving the brain in a different. A different order. I am being forced to select different words. I'm being forced to select a different order of comfortability. One is comfortability. I'm grabbing at that comfortability. I'm grabbing at. Well, I still have to think, don't I? I still have to think. So all of this is going on. I have to think and. It is a strange donation because it makes me more animated. There's nothing I can say about it, but it is making me more animated a character. And I'm absolutely not an animated character in American English. In American English, I'm quite sedate. But when I get flipped over into England, I am more animated. And you will find that also, I believe. You start yours. You can find yourself a little bit more exuberant, perhaps. Exuberant, perhaps even more jovial. More jovial, more. What is the terminology now I'm needing? I have to go out and grab at it. Where is this terminology? Just more fun, in a way. It is a fun language. Don't be scared of Britain. Don't be scared of British English. It is something quite cherishable, quite endearing, and gosh dang it, there's a lot of people who say, oh no, it's just, they're too class oriented, they're just no fun, they're just all about themselves and their wealth and their money and their this and all that, but you know, give yourself a try and find out where you are in your muscles, in your facial, in your particular abilities and skills. Where is your particular accent? Okay, where are you finding your comfortability? Yeah, so anyway, so this is really all I was talking about today. I just wanted to share this with you, that we can all develop. See, I try to switch off to the English. Develop. I can't write now. I can't. It's not such an easy flip out. Yeah, but it's slower. My English, my American English is slower. Like I'm going through a liquid of lava what I speak. But in Britain, I'm just on hot fire bubbles. It's different. So, yes, and it's a livelier brain in an odd way. I will not say it is a smarter brain. It is a more sociable brain. In retrospect, it is one that wants to be like talky talky, yucky yucky, more chatty, and more smiley, more energetic. I'm not going to say more giving, not any of that, but more cordial, definitely more cordial tone, and polite. Back to the very basic etiquettes of language itself. It is a politer tonation. It's just politer than the Irish. It is politer than the Americans. The Irish are often drifting off into, I will not diss them, but they are drifting off into a place that you cannot even hear, and it's undertoned, and they swallow the words often, and they're in there, like, what did they say? And you have to have ears like an elephant to pronounce, to you know, say it again, speak to me. You know, and so all of this is happening, and it's like, oh, speak louder. So there's a frustration with the Irish, is their quiet. Whereas the Americans, it's not that their tonations are quiet, and I can't say for all Americans, because we have the Southern American, and we have that crabby American woman who is quite crude when she speaks. She's a crude woman, and very hitive, you know, hitive in her discussion, hitive in how she speaks to people, like a block. You know, everywhere, blah, like she is throwing out her defenses first at you. Anything I can do, you can do better, that type. It's very, very dark and very hitting. Now that type of American woman is, there's nothing we can do about her. She's been trained this way. I've been even looking at movies here, briefly, watching the old westerns. And they've promoted women to be this curse style, tough and rough, whereas in British speak, the women are allowed, they are allowed that moment of propriety, that moment of, yes, I'm allowed to sit on a satin pillow, I am allowed to be a female. I am allowed to not have to compete with the male sex. Yes, so here we are. So these are my quick jives at, we have the American woman, that's the overdone introspective Irish brogue. And then we have the more sociable, and I will say more friendly. I want to say more amicable. I want to say more friendly. I want to say that the British tone is more hospitable. Like, if we went to an outing together, for instance, an expedition. We went over there to the theater. It would be a moment of everything is extremely, extremely non-barbaric. All right. So, anyway, it's fun. I am trying to push you guys, especially you Americans stuck in your, what do we call them, the heavy duty woman, or you're stuck in the meekness, or you want to bring more life into you, into who you are, into your presentation self. Go try the English out for a moment. Just try it out for a moment. It doesn't take very long. 5, 10 minutes a day. And in a short while, oh my gosh, you could move over there. You could move right over there, couldn't you? Anyway, that's it. That's all for today. Thank you for listening.